The Philippines logged nearly 2,000 new COVID-19 cases Thursday, the highest in over 4 months. The number of active cases now stands at 11,370, which is the highest since April 26. 3 new deaths were also reported. The COVID positivity rate in the Philippines also continues to rise as more cases of highly transmissible Omicron subvariants are detected. But health officials say it's still unclear whether these sublineages are indeed fueling the increase in infections.
Nakita natin ano, that among our samples that we have sequenced for these past weeks, BA.5 yung pinakamadami nating nadidetect. Pero kailangan mag-iingat tayo sa pag-conclude no, dito sa ating mga nakikitang resulta. Kailangan alam natin at nasa konteksto tayo na ang ating genome sequencing process is being done purposively. It's hindi po natin nakakapture lahat na nagpo-positibo sa ating bansa and therefore, hindi lahat ng positibo ay nakakapag-undertake ng genome sequencing. Meaning, yun atin pong mga resulta might be biased.
Despite the uptick in cases, the country's average daily attack rate and healthcare utilization rate, which are indicators used to determine alert levels, remain low. Philippine government data show nearly 3 million Filipinos were jobless in May. The latest jobs figures also pointed to a rise in underemployment. More from Jackie Pascual.
The Philippine unemployment rose to 6% in May from 5.7% in April. This translates to 2.93 million Filipinos without a job. The Philippine Statistics Authority says the figure is much lower than last year's 7.7%, but is still above pre-pandemic level.
Pababa naman talaga yung ating unemployment rate, but still higher compared to the pre-pandemic level of 2019, kung saan yung baseline natin doon ay nasa 5.1%.
The PSA says opening up the economy has led to more jobs compared to last year, but there was a drop in jobs in many sectors due to the ongoing pandemic. And one of the casualties is the education sector.
Primary elementary education for children without special needs, may bawas tayo na 104,000. At yung pangalawa, yung pre-primary preschool education for children without special needs, may bawas tayo na 103,000.
The executive director of a school in Mandaluyong asserts many schools have closed down either temporarily or permanently.
Maraming mga employees, both teaching and non-teaching staff, na nawalan ng trabaho.
The Labor Department was not surprised with the PSA figures, saying there were a lot of unemployed because many just graduated in May. Labor Secretary Bienvenido Laguesma notes another cause for concern is the underemployment rate, which rose to 14.5% in May.
Yung challenge na ano, yung sa underemployment, kasi that means quality of employment remains to be an issue, a challenge for us.
The labor chief says he is in talks with various government agencies as well as the private sector to improve the skills of Filipinos.
We are now reviewing and finalizing yung labor and employment plan for the year 2022 to 2028. Lahat ng departments may kinalaman sa buhay ng manggagawa at kanilang pamilya, magtulong-tulong.
The National Economic and Development Authority says they are pushing for job creation by improving quality of education and skills training. Schools are also optimistic the return of face-to-face classes will generate more jobs. Government is hopeful they can add not just additional jobs, but quality employment. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine peso slides further against the U.S. dollar. The local currency closed at 56.06 against the greenback on Thursday. This marks its weakest showing in nearly 17 years or since September 2005. A weak peso means the country has to pay more for its imports, such as oil and food. The Philippine Central Bank Governor Felipe Medalla earlier downplayed the depreciation of the currency, saying it was caused by the strengthening of the U.S. dollar. But he also said the central bank would participate in the market to address excessive short-term volatility.